I'm Jonah Buchanan, and in this video, what we're going to do is to look at a vocal production technique, which is the idea of ducking delays. What we want to do is to have a delay effect added to a vocal, but we only want that delay effect to be heard at particular points within the track, and we're going to use a clever bit of gating to make that happen. Here's the track as it stands right now, without any delay at all.
Loving ain't simple with you anymore. We have become
okay, so delays are a really nice way of adding a little bit of echo to a vocal and just giving it a little bit of space within the mix. So the first thing we're going to do is to set up a delay on this track. You can see that at the moment it's using a little bit of reverb, but nothing else. So what we're going to do now is just simply set up a new auxiliary bus, turn up the volume of that. I'm going to make it stereo because what I want to do is to use the stereo delay option within Logic. What stereo delay allows me to do is to have a separate left and right channel delay. So the echoes on this vocal will be different depending on the left and right channels. And at the moment, you can see that at the moment, the left channel is going to be a quarter note and the right channel is going to be an eighth note. And if I want to, I can change these. I'm actually going to make the one on the right-hand side a dotted eighth note. And the other thing that's actually really worth bearing in mind, particularly when you're working on sounds that you want to add delays to that have a really wide frequency range, is that you have a chance to change that range if you want to, let's say, exclude maybe the bottom end out of the delay. And I want to do that here. I don't want the lowest frequencies of the vocal channel to echo. I just want the sort of brighter frequencies to do that. So you can see that I've used a little bit of low cut just to scoop the low end out of this delay. Okay, so with the delay in place, what we should hear is that very clearly. If I solo the vocal, we should hear those echoes.
Loving ain't simple with you anymore. We have become
okay, and sure enough, there they are. Now, the only issue here, even in the context of just hearing this by itself, is that these delays are clearly too much and they're getting in the way. And what I want to do is to make sure that they only really make their presence felt in the gaps between the individual phrases. So what I need to do is to find a way to make those delays not make a noise whilst the vocalist is actually performing. And the way that I'm going to do that is to use Logic's gate plugin. So after the delay, what I'm going to do is to come into Dynamics. I'm going to come and find the noise gate. Now, the way that gating normally works is that it requires a signal to come into a gate to tell that gate to open. Now, if you think about it, we want the opposite to happen here. If I decide to tell this gate to open when the vocalist sings, then every time she sings, the gate will open, and then I get delays on top of the bits that I don't want to have delays on. So that's a problem. What I almost want to do is to say, actually, I want the gate to remain closed until she stops singing, at which point I want it to open. Well, the great thing about the gate is that it has two modes. One of those is called gate, and the other one is called ducker. And that does precisely what I'm describing. It means that the gate will open only when the volume drops below a certain threshold. And that's exactly what I want. When there is no threshold, when there's nothing pushing this channel open, that's when I want this to open up and allow us to hear the effect of what this channel is doing. So before this is actually just going to work, what I actually need to do is to route the vocal into this plugin via what's called a sidechain source. I'm going to come to my audio tracks and I'm going to go and find the vocal. And now what I've done is I've said to the gate, I want you to listen to the vocal channel and I want you to respond to it. That's what setting up a sidechain means. And now what I have a chance to do is to decide a range of things depending on how I want this, this ducking technique to behave. So let's have a look at those. I'm going to press play, and what we're going to see is that the vocal is going to respond first of all to the threshold. At what volume point do I want ducking to occur? And then how much volume change do I want there to be? And what you can also see is I've got an opportunity to control attack, hold, and release times, which are going to control the behavior of how quickly or slowly the noise gate or the ducker in this particular case behaves in those gaps. Let's have a listen and configure these settings as we go.
Loving ain't simple with you anymore. We have become opposites. No, loving ain't simple with you anytime. Battle lines drawn.
Okay, so actually I haven't touched those dials because it's just interesting to see how this works. You can hear straight away that it's kind of doing what we want it to, which is that whilst the singer is singing, we don't get any delay. And when she stops, the gate opens. Now, the only problem is that it's doing that sort of too quietly. What we need to do is to configure a range of things just to get these settings behaving a little bit more like we'd like them to. So let's listen again, and this time we're going to adjust a few parameters.
Loving ain't simple with you anymore. We have become opposites. No, loving ain't simple with you anytime. Battle lines drawn.
So that's working much better. What we've done so far is I've adjusted, first of all, the threshold point. And what that's doing is it's making sure that the gate doesn't have to work so hard. The volume doesn't have to drop so much in order for the gate to open. Crucially, what I've also done is I've controlled both the attack time and the release time. What that's doing is controlling how quickly the ducker opens and closes. So we get a much more natural response as each phrase opens to give us those delays. Rather than being a very brutal sort of snap, open and close process, what we've done is to just sort of massage the way that each individual open instance of this opening and closing behaves. And as a result, it's much more contoured towards the vocal. Now, you could easily look at these settings and think, right, okay, those are the ones that I'm going to use. But remember, this is completely volume dependent. So the reason why these settings appear to be working all right for me is because of the particular volume that my vocal is being performed at. You'll find that you need different settings to these depending on the volume at which it's been recorded and the context of what it is that you're trying to do, and also the tempo of your track. I want my delays just to sort of smear in the gaps in this particularly slow, ambient sort of tune. If you want to do this within the context of an EDM record or something which is much faster, then again, you're going to need different attack and release times. Let's hear that in context now and just see how it's working within the piece.
Loving ain't simple with you anymore. We have become opposites. No, loving ain't simple with you anytime. Battle lines drawn.
Okay, that's working well within the context of this piece, but there are a couple of things that I want to do just to sort of tighten this up. I like the way that the noise gate and the ducking technique is working, but what I want to do is to just take a little bit of brightness out of the delays, just so they're a little bit more smeared and not quite so sharp and focused. So now what we've effectively got sort of is a bandpass filter on both sides of this delay. We've rolled out some of the bottom and some of the top just to leave the sort of mid-range elements of the vocal, those frequency groups. And what I'm also going to do is I'm just going to address the volume as well. At the moment, these delays are too loud. So what I'm going to do is to take their volume down. Now, it's worth bearing in mind that because the fader comes after those processes we've looked at, none of this is going to affect the way that the gate behaves. Those threshold points are still going to behave exactly the way that they did before. The fader simply allows me to turn the volume of this effect down afterwards. Let's have a listen to that.
Loving ain't simple with you anymore. We have become opposites. No, loving ain't simple with you anytime. Battle lines drawn.
Okay, I pushed it up a little bit. That first volume that I selected was too quiet. But you can see that the effect of just taking out the top end from the actual delay itself has just made those a little bit more blunted. I like that. And what I've also done, as we've seen, is to make sure that the return volume of this particular fader is set at a point where we're just getting the amount of those delays that we want. So within this video, what we've done is we've looked at the fact that in addition to being a regular noise gate, that particular plugin can also act as a ducker, which does the opposite. Rather than opening when a sound exceeds a certain volume point, what it does is it waits for the volume to drop before opening. And what we've then done is to configure a range of its parameters to allow us to control dynamically a series of delays on this vocal part.